Hey YouTube, today I'm heading to Bangkok on Korean Air. It's been a couple of years since I last flew on Korean Air. Fortunately, I was able to get a great deal on round-trip economy seats once again. Unlike last time, however, I'll be traveling during Thailand's monsoon season. I got to the airport just under 3 hours before departure.
Surprisingly, security was a total breeze, and now I've got about 2 hours for liftoff, and I'm gonna go try and find a lounge.
This trip will be operated in two segments, about 14 hours from New York to Incheon. In between, I'll have about 2.5 hours in Incheon, and then another 6 hours from Incheon to Bangkok. I'm a Priority Pass member, so I plan to visit the Air France lounge here at JFK before departure.
Here we are. It's so unassuming from the outside. Priority pass 8 to 13, so that's good. It leaves me about 30 minutes before my flight, and then 23 to 0:30. So let's give it a shot.
The Air France lounge at JFK was nice, although only the main level was open to Priority Pass customers. The lounge had a small dining area, comfortable chairs. However, it didn't offer any airside views. There was a high-tech coffee machine, but the star of the lounge was the immense French wine collection. The food selection, however, was a little sparse. I'd hoped to load up on a little bit of food before boarding a long flight, so this visit was a little bit of a disappointment. At least the champagne was good.
It's 15 minutes until boarding time, and there's already a line for economy, so I guess I better get to it. Thank you, JFK, for having these things.
My first flight will be operated by a 9-year-old A380. Economy class on board will be in a 3-4-3 configuration. Korean Air uses the entire upper deck on the A380 for its business class, while the main level is split between first class and economy. I'll be in 36K. On long flights, Korean Air provides all seats with a small bottle of water, a small sleep kit, headphones, pillow, and a blanket.
What I hate about the Korean Air A380, no air vent.
I was excited to have an empty seat between me and the aisle. According to Korean Air's website, international flights to Incheon follow the same itinerary. A heavy meal just after takeoff, a snack service about midway through, and a second meal just before landing. Time for takeoff. Economy sleep kit came with a pair of slippers and a toothbrush and toothpaste kit. Korean Air did not offer eye masks.
So here's the restroom. It's just fresh enough to take off. It's for economy class. It's not too bad. It's about 24 inches across. There's a semi full length mirror, perfumes, and body lotion. Interesting.
The IFE on the A380 offered a wide selection of Western and Korean movies, shows, games, and music. My only issue with the IFE was that it seemed a bit laggy at times. Unlike other carriers, Korean Air does not offer in-flight Wi-Fi service, because they did not want passengers to be disappointed with how slow it was. As of 2019, this was still the case. The first meal service began about an hour in. What I love about Korean Air is that every meal is served with metal utensils. I went with beef with potatoes and vegetables, which is pretty good. As an alternative, there was also a vegetarian pasta dish. After the meal and duty-free service, it was time to cuddle up under a blanket and get some sleep. A snack service was offered about 7 hours into the flight to those who were awake. I was offered a brownie, prawn chips, and a banana. Previous flights also offered ramen cups and rice balls. A few hours later, the cabin lights brightened for the final meal service. The crew came around with hot scented towels for every passenger. It was a nice way to power back up. What's interesting about this flight is that there was daylight from takeoff through the entire flight. After the towels were collected, it was time for the next meal.
We have three choices, two kind of Chinese style. It's Mongolian beef with fried rice, or chicken with fried rice also. They're known as Western made of pasta.
Beef rice.
Again, I opted for the beef, which came with rice and vegetables. It also came with a salmon salad and warm pretzel bread. Everything was very good.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the captain speaking. We expect to land at Incheon International Airport in about 40 minutes. The local time is 4:24 p.m. Thank you for flying with us today. I'm Sakta.
Overall, the flight in the A380 was good, although I didn't feel as comfortable or rested as I did on previous flights. The cabin of the A380 is pretty quiet, so I didn't hear much discernible engine noise. Now it's time for my 2.5 hour connection in Incheon. We arrived at Terminal 2. The last time I flew in Korean Air, we connected through Terminal 1, so this was the first time I was in Terminal 2. Like in Terminal 1, I expected a quick and easy transfer through security and a gorgeous terminal. Incheon was also known for having free shower facilities for connecting passengers, so I was looking forward to that. After the shower, I planned to explore the terminal and grab a snack somewhere before boarding my flight to Bangkok. Incheon Airport also offers a free transit tour for passengers with long layovers. I'll be sure to sign up for one on my way back to New York.
So it took about 15 minutes between the time I got off the plane, got through security, and came back up here, and now I'm on the departures level of Terminal 2, which is what Korean Airlines operate out of. I have a little over an hour or so I'm probably gonna find something to eat, and also maybe take a shower.
Incheon's Terminal 2 was gorgeous. Throughout the day, the airport provided a number of cultural experiences, like musical performances and cultural parades, for passengers. The terminal itself was very easy to navigate, but also offered informational robots and interactive maps throughout the terminal. There were even free baby strollers in case anyone needed one.
So much trouble. So I'm checking out the transit lounge, which is one more floor up on the fourth floor. There are signs for showers, so I'm hoping that it's not a priority pass lounge, but an actual legit transit lounge.
The transit lounge had plenty of comfy seats and even a sleep room. It also offered paid services like dining and spa facilities. The best service it offered, in my opinion, was the free shower for passengers. In Terminal 1, The showers were staffed and required passengers to show their connecting boarding passes. In this case, I was able to walk right in, grab a towel, and head to a vacant shower room.
It's free. And it comes with a towel, unlike in Taipei. So it's the usual shower stuff. Personal toilet, kind of. I'm not sure what's in here. Oh, great. Place to hang your clothes. Shower's done. I feel like a totally different person. I'm so glad this is here. I'm glad it was free. I'm glad that I was able to just walk right in. Now it's time to find something to eat and maybe get some Korean treats. So we just came out of the 7-Eleven here at the airport and I'm a little disappointed. Really, I think everything they have here, I can find in H Mart. There's nothing exotic about it. Anything here at all. It might just be because it's at the airport, but still.
The dining facilities in Terminal 2 are located in the middle of the terminal on the fourth floor, right by the members-only airport lounges. There are many stalls and restaurants to choose from. In this location, I was able to order my meal of choice from a kiosk.
So I got some spicy Korean fried chicken from one of the stalls and a beer. This was about 11 bucks. Chicken was really good. Now it's time to head to the gate. I still have some sauce on me.
I'm at gate 261, waiting to board the 659 to Bangkok. And it's gonna be operated by an A330, and it's a 6-hour flight with a snack and meal service each. So hopefully I won't get hungry like I did on the last flight, and it'll be a nice and smooth one. This flight will get me to Bangkok just around midnight, and once I get there, I'm hoping that I'll be able to get through customs and immigration quickly, and then try to get some rest.
Thank you. Hello.
The Korean Air A330 operates in a two-class configuration. There are 24 prestige sleeper seats in the front and 252 economy class seats in a 242 configuration in the back.
Thank you. Okay. No bottle of water, no sleep kit. Much better view though.
Like the A380, this 19-year-old A330 had no personal air vent, but did offer an underseat power outlet. The legroom on the A330 was also very good. I was especially delighted to have an empty seat next to me again. Now it was time for the final 6-hour leg of this trip. A330's IFE offered the same entertainment options as its A380 counterpart. Surprisingly, this IFE was much more responsive than the one on the A380. After settling in at cruising altitude, it was time for meal service.
White is good. White, sorry.
Oh, thank you.
So dinner tonight is codfish with potatoes. I asked for a red wine and then realized I was eating fish, so I asked for a white wine. She was so sweet, she gave me one of each. What I loved about the A330 was the ability to lean on the cabin wall. This was nearly impossible to do on the A380 because of the distance between the cabin wall and the seat.
The bathroom in the A330 is nothing spectacular, but it does come with a lot of toothbrushes.
Now it was time for a short nap. Before you knew it, we began our initial descent into Bangkok. Overall, my trip on the A330 was great. Although the meal wasn't spectacular, the service by the crew was phenomenal and actually felt more personable than on the A380. I would absolutely fly them again.
Thank you.
Hi.
Thank you.
So in Bangkok and heading to customs and immigration. And we landed in gate E9. E9 is literally the furthest gate away from everything. So I'm tired and trying to get there a little faster. Well, I made it through. I got lucky, it was painless. Then I get a SIM card and go get some sleep. Thanks for watching. See you next time.
If you found this video useful, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to us on here and on Instagram. It really helps us a lot. Until next time, bye!